Hi, this is Gabriela Ortiz for the Stata YouTube channel. I'd like to show you how to embed Stata output in text files, Word documents, and HTML files with Stata's dynamic document commands. To embed Stata output in any of these file formats, you begin with a text file that includes the text you want and the Stata commands you want to run. We enclose the Stata commands within dynamic tags, which indicate how commands, output, results of expressions, and graphs should be inserted in a document. If you want to embed Stata output in a text file, you would use the dyndoc command and specify the plain text file. Or if you simply want to convert a Markdown document to an HTML file or a Word document, you would use the Markdown command. But if you want to combine Stata output and Markdown text in your document, you can use the dyndoc command to create HTML and Word documents. This command calls on dyndoc to process the Stata commands, and it calls on Markdown to process the Markdown formatted text. The dyndoc and dyndoc commands create dynamic documents, meaning that as your data change, you can simply rerun these commands to create an updated version of your document. And by using the DD version tag, you can recreate your document in any future version of Stata. When creating HTML and Word documents, you have a lot of flexibility. For example, to create a Word document, simply specify the docx option. Or if you want to include graphics in your HTML files as base64 encoded images instead of links, just use the embed image option. To use relative links in your text file, simply specify the base directory with Markdown. And you can streamline your work process by using macros with the DD include tag. I'll briefly demonstrate how you can use some of these features. Let's begin by embedding Stata output in a text file. I want to create a report on high blood pressure with the output from a logistic regression and margins, so I have put together the following text file. Note that I used the DD version tag at the top. The version changed from 1 in Stata 15 to 2 in Stata 16. Including this tag allows me to recreate this document in any future version of Stata, similar to using the version command. Here, I include a title for the report. Then, I add a brief description of the dataset, which is the NHANES 2 dataset. Next, I load the dataset with web use. The DDDO dynamic tag executes the Stata commands and embeds the output in the resulting file. Here, I add a brief description of the model we fit below. Then, I fit a logistic regression model of high blood pressure on weight, age group, and sex. Then, I add a brief comment on the regression results. And then I say we can compute the probability of having high blood pressure for males and females in each age group, and I compute those probabilities with margins. The last thing I add is a brief comment on the results from margins. So to generate a text file with the output from all these Stata commands, I can simply type dyndoc followed by the file name. And I'll save this as file1.txt. Here is the resulting file. Here you see the output from the logistic regression and the output from margins. Now suppose that I work at the Natural History Museum, and I want to create an HTML file that tracks museum attendance and gift shop sales. I have fictional datasets for the first two quarters of 2018, and I have already created bar graphs for each quarter with the following do file. Here I create a bar graph for the attendance in quarter 1, the gift shop sales in quarter 1, and similarly for quarter 2. Note that I save the graphs as PNG files in a folder called graphs. To create an HTML file with these images, I put together the following text file. The equal signs denote the title of our report, and the double pound signs denote headings for each quarter. Here I have 2018 first quarter and 2018 second quarter. And here I include the graphs I've previously saved, attend Q1 and G shop Q1, the bar graphs for attendance and gift shop sales for quarter 1, and similarly for quarter 2. To generate the HTML file, we can simply type the following. So I'll save this file as nhm.html. The embed image option embeds the image files, and because I used relative links for the image files, I need to specify the base directory. And here we get a link to the resulting HTML file. We could instead create a Word document by specifying the docx option or using the docx extension for the file name, in which case the docx option is implied. The embed image option doesn't apply here, and it will just be ignored when creating a Word document, but let's remove it. And now we'll save this as nhm.docx. Here is the resulting document. We created these HTML and Word documents in two steps. First, we created the graphs with a do file, and then we inserted them in the Markdown formatted text file. But you can actually do this in one step with dyndoc. For example, I have the following text file which I used to create quarterly reports for the museum. Note that I included the header text file with the DD include tag. This file contains HTML code to include at the top of the file we will create. Here is that header text file. Note that I have the same markdown formatted text as before, the title at the top, and the section headings. Here I have another DD include tag, and you'll note that here I used a macro. Each quarter, my colleague sends me a text file with a review of the events held during each quarter. And with this tag, I can include that content in the quarterly report. For example, here's the text file for the first quarter. In this file, we have a review of all the events held during January, February, and March. And here we have a review of the events for the second quarter, saved as Exhibit Q2. Here I have included the Stata commands that generate those graphs we previously embedded. The DDDo tag executes the code, and the quietly attribute suppresses the output. Instead of typing the dataset names for each quarter, I used macros. This way, I can use the same text file to generate the report for each quarter. Then I can issue the dataset names as arguments with the dyndoc command. So by using macros, I've generalized this text file. This tag will insert the graph created above. Similarly, this tag will insert the graph created above for gift shop sales. To generate the report for the first quarter of 2018, I would type the following. The first argument is the dataset for this quarter, and the second argument is the text file sent over by my colleague. And I'll save the resulting document as q1report.html. Here is the resulting document. Here you see the content from Exhibit Q1 and the graphs we created. And when I get the data and exhibit files for the second quarter, I can simply type the following. Here I've just updated the name of the dataset and the exhibit text file for quarter 2. And now we have q2report.html. Let's also create the report for the second quarter as a Word document by typing the following. I could add the docx option here, but this is implied with the docx extension of the file name. And here is the report for quarter 2 as a Word document. So this is how you can create reproducible documents with markdown formatted text and Stata output. If you would like to learn more about creating documents with markdown formatted text and Stata output, you can download the Stata Reporting Reference Manual from our website at stata.com. Thank you for watching.